Do you feel you guys
Yeah.
have stacked the deck with this one?
Yeah, honestly, yeah, you could, if it was like a scale of 1 to 10 in terms of like Bloodbath, it's 10. It really is. If you like the first one, you're gonna absolutely adore the second one. It is literally like the first one on steroids, like it's crazy.
It didn't stay buried. It's as if the earth itself was allowing this horror to rise up.
Thank you. How are you?
Doing well, man.
Good.
Causing a trail of blood. Okay,
Oh,
that's
God,
what last
yeah.
time I've seen you covered up. Okay, in a mask. Man,
Yeah.
how much fun was this to shoot? It looks
Oh
like it
my
would be a
God.
blast just watching this.
Yeah. Oh my God. So it was an absolute dream for me. And I honestly said it was an absolute dream. Like this character's like I've said to everyone, it's my dream role. And then he's just perfect for me. Just the high energy character, just tearing through people and just covered in blood at all times. So for me, it was an absolute blast. I was only on set for a little while, so I really tried to like enjoy every moment. Yeah, absolute dream for me it was.
Did you audition for any other roles in this, or was it always Tigger?
It was always Tigger. So yeah, literally, I left drama school and I was doing a play at the time. And then my agent sent me the character breakdown, saying I'm gonna put you forward for this. And it was said like, you know, heavy prosthetics. It said Freddy Krueger was inspiration, Pennywise was inspiration. All these like
Nice.
great characters. And I was like, this is literally my dream role. And I loved Tigger as a kid as well. I was like, this is my dream role. So I was desperate to get it. So I followed everyone on Instagram. And I remember Reese followed me back and texted me saying, can you send the self tape in? Sends it in, and then about 2 weeks later, I got the role. So it's always been Tigger. So I've always been sort of put forward as
Did you
day
see,
one.
were you aware of the first one prior? I know it just released a year ago. How much did
Yeah.
you know prior about the first film before you auditioned for this one?
So I knew of the first film. I hadn't watched it yet. I knew of it because it obviously went viral. So I remember seeing it on social media whilst I was at drama school at the time. And then so the minute I had it sent to me saying Winnie-the-Pooh, Bloods and Honey 2, I was like, oh, I know the first one. So I was instantly interested. And then I didn't actually watch it until I got the role. So I did the whole audition process, got the role. Then I was like, right, I have a month until I'm on set, so maybe it's time to watch the film. I watched it quite a few times. And then just to sort of get used to that universe they've created. Yeah.
What do you think fans of the first one will get in the second one? How much different is it going to be? How much bloodier, basically, is the
Oh,
question
God.
you feel the second
Yeah.
one is going to be? Do you feel you guys
Yeah.
have stacked the deck with this one?
Yeah, honestly, yeah, you couldn't, if it was like a scale of 1 to 10 in terms of like Bloodbath, it's 10. It really is. If you like the first one, you're gonna absolutely adore the second one. It is literally like the first one on steroids, like it's crazy. And obviously there's like singular kills in the first one, which is like it's a great style of horror film, obviously, where like people get picked off one by one. But this one's a lot more just complete bloodbath the whole way throughout. It's just complete chaos and carnage from start to finish, and it is like just buckets of blood. Like the amount of blood that was pretty used was just crazy. So if you like the first one, you're gonna love this one.
Do you have any say on the killings or made a pitch to Reese about how you want to take
Yeah.
out someone? Because I'd imagine, you know, with the blood splashing all over, maybe you had a little bit of a pitch there
Yeah.
to make.
I did, to be fair. I had a couple times. Me and Reese has gone really well. So I think there was one kill in particular. I can't say what it is, but it was one kill where I was sort of trying out something that was a quite like cat-like and sort of, you know, very agile. And he was going, yeah, I like that, I like that. But it's crazy because these guys are just geniuses. Like they literally, we had kills in the script, and like, but then we would get on set, and then I remember watching Reese, and he would like look around the DOP and go, I want to use this environment. Like, he's like, I want to use this part of the building in a kill. They just come up here on the spot and they go, right, Lewis, change of plan. This is what you're doing. And I was just so like excited to be there. So like, yep, whatever you say, I'm doing it. So it was crazy just to watch these guys come up, like look at the environment and use that to you know, kill.
Yeah, and then the costume. I mean, the mask is the thing, you know.
Yeah.
Did you know in advance what it would be, or when you arrived on set, that's when you found out too? What was sort of the costuming and that take your kind of reaction to it?
It was on set, so literally I've got the prosthetics fitted, and then they showed me concepts of the makeup. People showed me like concept art of what it might look like. And then obviously I think I for weeks didn't know what it was gonna look like. And then I think Reese sent me a grey mold of it. So it was just grey, no fur, no colour, nothing yet. So I kind of had an idea what it was gonna look like, and I got so excited until I remember this. I got on set, walked over to the makeup trailer, and I could see it there on a mannequin's head. I was like, oh my God, like this is real now. And it was there waiting for me, covered in like the color and the fur. And then once I got it on, and then obviously the blood over the mouth, I remember looking in the mirror and thinking like, okay, yeah, it's on.
Could you
You know,
breathe in it? What was it made out of? Like, what sort of it looks really elaborate. Like, it's not
yeah,
a plastic mask or anything. It looks like really well
no,
fitted and everything.
really. Yeah, really durable. Things like silicone, I think it's called, and it's obviously like a complete melt. Yeah, and it was in like four parts. You sort of back it over, you've got this like hood showing, and it's in four. So it's not a mask, it's prosthetics, and it kind of comes down to your chest and covers your shoulders. And then my face is like this. Then I have a forehead piece and a chin piece, and then the last bit to cover this part of the face. And then it felt like Darth Vader at the end of Revenge of the Sith. I keep saying this, but it felt like you could see these like eye holes coming towards you. And once it's on, you're like, I'm ready now. But I could breathe absolutely fine. I had nose. I could breathe out my nose, breathe out my mouth fine. The only thing, like the vision was perfect. The only thing that was bad was the hearing, because obviously his ears are here. So this was
That's
clearly covered.
right.
There was no holes. So the only thing was the hearing. So I remember I'd be on set at times, and the director would be like, "But Lewis, can we get you and your mark, please?" And I'd just be like, "But Lewis, about Lewis," and I'd be like, "Oh, sorry." So I learned a couple of times, but like, I just couldn't hear anything. I could hear myself fine, which is a bit annoying. But yeah, the only thing was the hearing. But I kind of got used to it.
Where'd you guys shoot? Because most of it is at night. It's dark everywhere. So, I mean, it's a setting for these sort of things. But where was the location that you guys were at?
So I was very lucky with the location. So I literally got the role, and I was thinking that this might be in the States, or this might be, North Country, or whatever. And then they went, "No, we're filming some of your like warehouse scenes in," with that, then pictures that come out of me in a warehouse. That was all filmed in South London, so quite close to me. I'm right on the south coast of England. And then all the woods part was filmed. So I'm in a place called West Sussex. It's a county, Sussex, yeah. And then the filming was in East Sussex. So I was literally like, that's like an hour and a half away from me. The chance of this, so I still had accommodation and stuff like that, and I still had to get a train over and people pick me up and stuff. But it was like getting home the next day was like easy as anything. So I was quite lucky. And obviously, like Pooh's from Canada and Piglet's from Scotland, and all these people flying over to be here. And I was just like literally just an hour and a half away, just sort of popped along.
You're the tour guide in that case, then.
Literally, yeah. I've got friends in East Sussex. My mate was just down the road, one of my best mates there, so I sort
Oh,
of knew
that's
the
amazing.
area.
Did you guys bond on set and offset with the group? Did you guys hang out or form a friendship? I mean, you're doing all these killings together. I imagine there's a bond that you're connecting here.
I'm trying not to give too much away, but I actually didn't. I didn't spend that much time with him on set. I only met Pooh once and very briefly. I only met Owl outside of production. I haven't even met Piglet yet. I haven't met Eddie, so I don't want to give too much away of the story, but I actually didn't. So I bonded really well with like the supporting artists and the crew. I mean, the crew could not have been any better to me. Like, they were so like caring and stuff. But in terms of like the other monsters, I only met Pooh very briefly, and Owl met a couple. That's it. So there wasn't a lot of sort of, we didn't have any scenes really together. Without trying to give too much away, but yeah.
Any potential here? You can make a return in future. Reese, did Reese give you any sort of hope for a return for a third one?
Yeah, so I've been told, all I can say is the producer told me, so I can confirm, which is very exciting news. I can confirm that Tigger will be back for future films. He will be back.
Yes, you made
And there
it.
also is a massive announcement on the 22nd of March. There's going to be a huge announcement for a new film that's coming out in this universe. So stay
Awesome.
tuned on Instagram and X and stuff like that, because it will be announced, yeah, 22nd of March. So
Okay,
very exciting future.
and we're getting a three night run here end of March in the US in the theater.
Yeah.
So people are gonna go out to see it and see you do work, literally.
Yeah, literally, I go to town 22nd, 27th, and no, 26th, 27th, 28th of
That's
March.
right.
Book your ticket through Fathom Events, and yeah,
Lewis,
enjoy.
it's been a pleasure catching up with you. This is not the Tigger anyone expects. This is a whole new
No,
version that you're creating
yeah.
here, and excited to see it come out in theaters. And hey, the future for your character here. So hopefully we catch up
Yeah,
down
yeah.
again on the next one.
Definitely, definitely let me know and I'll be there. Yeah. Thanks for
Hey,
your
this was
time.
fun.
Thank you.
Thank you, my
Cheers.
friend.